Hi, welcome to this week's Gamecock Insider. I'm your host, Andy Demetra. From the courts to the diamond, and even the open road, we have you covered this week on Gamecock Insider. But we begin on the links, where South Carolina women's golf just wrapped up play at the SEC Championship. The standout for head coach Kalen Anderson was junior Caitlin Dambaugh, who finished second overall for the Gamecocks. As you'll find out, wherever Caitlin plays, she carries the memory of a loved one with her.
When junior golfer Caitlin Dambaugh was a senior in high school, she found out what sacrificing for your country truly meant. Major Walter David Gray was an air liaison officer in the 13th Air Support Operations Squadron, who married Caitlin's close family friend.
Oh, he was an amazing guy. He was really funny. I was his flower girl in his wedding when I was six. So it was a couple years before that, I guess, is when I officially met him.
Growing up, Caitlin remembered David always being a present force in her life. But on August 8, 2012, Major Gray was killed by a suicide bomber in Kunar Province, Afghanistan.
My team of six were protecting our brigade commander, and we had an element of 28 coalition forces to include Afghan National Army, and we were in Assadabad, the city of Assadabad, walking in down the street. We were going to a security meeting when we were targeted by two suicide bombers. And he had a dead man's trigger, which means he had already pressed the trigger prior to walking towards us. And as he hit the ground chest first, he let go the trigger and he detonated.
I was at home after golf practice one day, and we heard that from our pastor that someone had died and was killed over in Afghanistan because his daughter married a guy in the Air Force. And so our pastor called us and told us about it the night it happened, and we were just I was in complete shock. Like, my whole family, we were just crying. Like, we had no idea what was going on. We didn't think it was real, and you know, it was just a really hard time for all of us.
In the months after, Caitlin struggled to get back on the golf course.
I mean, it was hard. It was really hard to go back to doing, you know, daily routines and all that, because he was on my mind nonstop, and his wife Heather and his three kids, he has three young children. They were all on my mind constantly. I mean, it took a while for me to be able to get back out there and, you know, go through the regular routine, but no matter what, like, I always thought that he would be wanting me to do my best and just keep doing what I do.
Although Major Gray now lives as a memory in Caitlin's mind, she still takes with her the lessons that she has learned through David's sacrifices.
You know, he was someone who, unfortunately, ended up paying the ultimate sacrifice for doing something that he was passionate about. And I just think that that's the main thing, like, that he wants people to know. Like, he felt like that was his calling, like, that's what he was supposed to do, and, you know, that's what he did.
Dambaugh credits the strength that she has learned from Major Gray near the top of the list for the success that she has earned in her college golf career. And much of that is because she carries him with her every time she plays.
My coach allowed me to put David's name on my bag in his honor. And inside my bag is a piece of paper that has his story, like how I knew him, like, and all that stuff. And, you know, it's just really cool to be able to honor him in that way. And everybody asks me about the bag, like, who is that on your bag when I go to tournaments and when I'm just practicing. And I love talking about him because, I mean, he's somebody who should be known.
And our thanks to Caitlin for sharing her story with us. Still to come on Gamecock Insider, South Carolina baseball has reached the midway mark of SEC play, tied for the best record in the conference. What'll it take to stay there? Head coach Chan Holmberg visits exclusively with us. That's next.
Gamecock Insider is brought to you by Coke Zero. Enjoy everything. By Colonial Life, the benefits of good hard work. And by Wild Wing Cafe, we've got just the thing to make you wild. Gamecock Insider is a production of Gamecock IMG Sports Marketing.
America's workers are passionate about building better lives for themselves and their families. Colonial Life is passionate about helping them with benefits that preserve and protect what they work so hard to build. Even if challenging times get in their way, when you need us most, we're there, and we've been there for 75 years. Colonial Life, the benefits of good, hard work.
Win the opportunity to be the next Farm Bureau Insurance fan in the field and witness pregame warm-ups from the dugout. Winners will receive two game tickets, pregame field passes, and autographed merchandise from head coach Chad Holbrook. Visit usccontest.com to register today. Fan on the Field is brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Get the membership advantage.
All your old technology. So what about this? It's time to get into the new with Ford. New is EcoBoost technology. New is a foot-activated liftgate. New is tougher, stronger, and lighter. New is Ford, America's best-selling brand. Now, get into a new Fusion for $179 or 0 for 60 plus 2,000 trade assist. See your Carolina Ford dealer today.
Join us every week at Wild Wing Cafe for Carolina Calls from 7 to 8 p.m. Wild Wing Cafe is Columbia's home for hot wings, cold beer, and good times. Tune in to Carolina Calls every week and go to wildwingcafe.com for more information.
Within the scope of being impossible to reach, it's that 1-2. Watts at third base. Can they turn two? Yes, they do. Finish with a flare for the Gamecocks, who avoid the series sweep and pick up the 7-5 win.
That was our Sansbury Ice Center. Did you see them play this week on Gamecock Insider? Welcome back. Andy Demetra here at Founders Park with South Carolina head baseball coach Chad Holbrook. And coach, you've reached the midway mark of SEC play, tied for the best record in conference at 11-4. Things didn't quite go the way you wanted in Athens, but still halfway through the 30-game SEC schedule. How do you feel about where your team is right now?
Well, you got to feel pretty good. I mean, it's obviously a very tough league. We didn't play especially well in Athens, but we've played well over the course of time, and we put ourselves in a good position. We put ourselves in a spot where we can accomplish some great things. But we got to play well the second half, and that's going to be the focus as we move forward here. Let's try to go 1-0 in our next game. Let's try to put the past behind us. Yeah, we're 11-4, and we got that in the bank. But let's try to go 11-4 again. And then if you do that, boy, you got something special. So let's take it one game at a time. Let's appreciate where we are. But let's try to improve.
Gene Cohen keeps on swinging, a 23-game hitting streak entering this week. This was the guy who batted leadoff for you last year, but what has made him such a better leadoff man this year compared to last year?
Well, he's got some experience. His confidence is at an all-time high. He's gotten stronger, believe it or not, even though he's still skinny. He's worked hard in the weight room, and he just feels better about himself. He's not chasing pitches out of the strike zone. He's handling himself very, very well, not trying to do too much, and taking what the pitcher gives him. And when the walk's there, he takes a walk. So he's been a great offensive player for us.
He's been really tough at the plate, but then again, Clark Schmidt has been really tough on the mound. A lot of guys having a hard time hitting. Your sophomore, who this week is tied for the nation's lead with 8 wins, tied for the nation's lead with 80 strikeouts. Clark Schmidt is our Terminex Pest Player of the Week. And boy, that start he had in Athens was something special.
He was good, and he's been good all year long. He's put up numbers. He's been very, very consistent. He's having an All-American type year, and we just need him to keep doing what he's been doing and not try to do too much. And but, boy, he's getting us off to a good start on Friday night, and I don't know if there's a pitcher out there I'd rather give the ball to than Clark Schmidt.
A complete game, five-hitter with 10 strikeouts, no walks against the team that he grew up rooting for in the Georgia Bulldogs. Of course, that series didn't come without a cost in our Palmetto Health Injury Report. A couple of guys battling some nagging injuries. You had Marcus Mooney with the hip pointer, Alex DeCino with the strained hamstring. He came back the next day, not only had a sensational diving catch and left, but a pair of big RBIs. That had to mean, I'm sure, a lot for just the demeanor of your dugout.
Yeah, it was. I mean, those kids both exuded some toughness. They didn't feel well, and we're a little bit shorthanded over the weekend, and hopefully this week Marcus will get back to 100%, as will Alex, and we certainly need to be 100% going forward to be the team that we want to be, but those guys laid it on the line for our team and did very, very well, and I'm glad they're on our team and in our dugout.
You started strong in the SEC, now halfway home. What will it take to finish strong in the league?
Well, just keep improving and play well and start swinging the bat a little bit better. You know, the last couple of weeks, it's been a little bit of a struggle for us offensively. We got to pick it back up, swing it the way we were early in the year, and I think that's going to happen. It's just going to take one double down the line with the bases loaded or one bloop to fall in for us and drive in a couple, and then we'll get that good feeling back.
All right, Chad, we appreciate it. Thanks for the time.
Thanks, Andy.
Coming up on Gamecock Insider, Tiffany Mitchell has caught the fever, or maybe more specifically, the fever have caught Tiffany Mitchell. We'll check in with the Gamecock's newest WNBA draft pick next.
If it wasn't for the University of South Carolina, we never would have started it.
We had an idea for a new way to create digital trees for video games and movies. So we decided to start SpeedTree through the USC Technology Incubator. Now, our software has been used in more than 50 feature films.
The fact that a couple of USC grads can have such a huge impact on Hollywood and even win an Academy Award, that's what No Limits means to us.
Win the opportunity to be the next Farm Bureau Insurance fan in the field and witness pregame warm-ups from the dugout. Winners will receive two game tickets, pregame field passes, and autographed merchandise from head coach Chad Holbrook. Visit usccontest.com to register today. Fan in the Field is brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Get the membership advantage.
You've upgraded all your old technology, so what about this? It's time to get into the new with Ford. New is EcoBoost technology. New is a foot-activated liftgate. New is tougher, stronger, and lighter. New is Ford, America's best-selling brand. Now, get into a new Fusion for $179 or 0 for 60 plus 2,000 trade assist. See your Carolina Ford dealer today.
Welcome back to Gamecock Insider, everyone. Last week, we spotlighted South Carolina senior guard Tiffany Mitchell and her culmination of a lifelong dream by getting drafted in the WNBA. But before Tiffany embarked on her professional career, she has one last exit interview, and that's with us here on Gamecock Insider. Enjoy.
The road I should have taken to get to this point that I am in my life. I don't know if this would be the same result if I would have went to any other school. The actual draft day, it was kind of long and anticipated, drawn out till 7 o'clock. So we were doing a lot of pre-draft, like getting hair and makeup done, you know, talking to head of ESPN. So it was just really a lot of stuff to kind of keep us busy. But I was still kind of just thinking about 7 o'clock the whole time, ready just to get things started, just to hear where my name was called at. I was projected between 5 and 10. So after 7, I was kind of like, just kind of looking around. My mom, she's like, just looking at me like it's all right. And then me and Coach Daly are kind of just like looking at each other. So I'm just really anxious now. Like I'm kind of just on the edge of my seat, just wondering when my name will be called.
With the 9th pick in the 2016 WNBA draft, the Indiana Fever select Tiffany Mitchell from the University of South Carolina.
and then when it finally was called at 9, it was kind of like a relief, like a sigh of relief, like finally. So it was a good moment and a good feeling. I was really excited. I talked to the head coach probably once, but I had previous conversation with other teams a lot more. So I was kind of like thrown off a little bit when Indiana did choose me. It is a dream come true, you know, growing up watching Coach Daly play, you know, watching WNBA, having that luxury of having a team in the city that you grew up as a little girl. You kind of, you know, desire to be in their same position. So when the roles are kind of reversed and, you know, Coach Daly's watching me get my name called, it's just really good feeling to have that moment shared with her. And I'm really excited to play with Tamika. I know she's a legend in the WNBA and she's about to retire. She's kind of like the Kobe of the WNBA this year. So it's really cool to kind of be on her team and witness her day in and day out. So I'm really excited about that. I just actually had a conversation with the head coach. She's just telling me she's really excited about the fact that she can coach me. She felt like I came from a great program, especially under Coach Daly. They kind of hang their hats on defense. And as you know, Coach Daly is a really defensive mindset coach. So she felt like I'd be a good fit for their program as far as how I approach the game. I think Coach Daly, my teammates, past teammates, and the coaching staff really just helped me prepare myself for this moment right here and to get to be professional.
And don't forget to circle your calendars, Gamecock fans. Sunday, May 29th, Tiffany Mitchell and the Indiana Fever take on the Atlanta Dream in Atlanta. Still to come on Gamecock Insider, our own Brad Muller sits down with South Carolina head women's golf coach Kaylin Anderson in advance of their run in the NCAA tournament. That's next. Introducing the Tex-Mex Bacon Thick Burger with fire-roasted peppers and onions, smoky Santa Fe sauce, and thick-cut bacon on a 100% Black Angus beef patty. New at Hardee's. Shop for groceries at Bylo and get Gamecock baseball tickets for free. When you spend a minimum of $50 at Bylo in one transaction, you can redeem your receipt at the ticket office to get two free tickets to an upcoming home game at Founders Park. Bylo, premier grocery partner of Gamecock Athletics.
Britons of Columbia has Gamecock attire for men and ladies with accessories to match from brands like Southern Tide and Smathers and Branson. Stop by Britons of Columbia or like Britons on Facebook.
America's workers are passionate about building better lives for themselves and their families. Colonial Life is passionate about helping them. With benefits that preserve and protect what they work so hard to build. Even if challenging times get in their way. When you need us most, we're there, and we've been there for 75 years. Colonial Life, the benefits of good, hard work.
When you grow up in a place, it's not just where you're from, it's who you are. The way things are done there becomes just how they're done. And while other places are nice, none of them quite feel like home. We're proud to say we grew up in the South, where serving you best starts with a conversation. Visit us at your nearest South State location or at southstatebank.com.
People ship all kinds of things.
But what if that thing is a few hundred thousand doses of flu vaccine
that need to be kept at 41 degrees
while being shipped to a country where it's 90 degrees in the shade?
Sound hard? Yeah.
Does that mean people in Laos shouldn't get their vaccine?
We didn't think so.
From figuring it out to getting it done,
we're here to help.
Hard work has earned Aaron Neuenfeld the title of Colonial Life Academic Athlete of the Week. A member of the beach volleyball team, Neuenfeld is a junior elementary education major with a 3.956 GPA. This week's academic athlete is brought to you by Colonial Life. Colonial Life, the benefits of good hard work. Welcome back, everyone. For the last several years under head coach Kalen Anderson, the South Carolina Gamecocks women's golf team has been a fixture in the NCAA championships. They'll begin their charge next weekend as they open up play in the NCAA regionals. Our own Brad Muller recently sat down with head coach Kalen Anderson.
Welcome back to the Gamecock Insider. Brad Muller joined by South Carolina women's golf coach Kalen Anderson. Gamecocks getting ready for their 18th consecutive trip to the NCAA tournament. Coach, I know an exciting time of year for you. You've had a terrific spring, three top five finishes. What do you like about your team heading into the postseason?
You know, our top three have been really, really solid for us with Caitlin Damba, Sarah Schmelzel, and I know Alara. They've just been really rock steady and really propelled the team. And, you know, we're just looking to get kind of four and five to step in there and mix it up a little bit and hopefully give us a good four score.
What's been the difference for you guys carrying over from the fall into the spring?
You know, I think we just, you know, came in with a little bit more focus. We had the additions of Marianne Vessier, and she's been huge in terms of just her experience coming into the lineup. And obviously we have a first semester freshman in there from as an international, which is always an adjustment period, but she's done a good job building some confidence in the lineup and putting in some good rounds. And, you know, I think we just came in with a little bit of a chip on our shoulder after the fall. We did not have the fall we were expecting. And, you know, they've worked hard and really taken accountability for it.
Caitlin Damba has had a tremendous year. I think five top five finishes, SEC runner-up. What are the strengths of her game?
Oh, she's unbelievable. Her length would be first and foremost her strongest point. But, you know, she's just solid all over the place and just the consistency. In the last year, she's matured so much on the golf course just mentally and with her decision-making, the way she thinks and her attitude. And, you know, she just stays patient and she knows the birdies are coming. She's able to go low and, you know, she just hangs in there. And I think that's been huge. And even, you know, her bad rounds have gotten much better. You know, her off days are 1-2 over par at the most. And then obviously she's got the ability to shoot the 66.
Your team won this regional last year. How much does that help going into the postseason this year?
Absolutely. I mean, experience. You have Sarah and Sarah coming back and Caitlin and then Jason. I know it was around for that win. So, you know, the experience of it. We've won three times. And I think, you know, they really like to step it up here in the postseason. And hopefully we'll do it again and just prepare like we've been doing. But it's definitely nice to have a few of those under your belt.
All right, Coach. Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Coach Kalen Anderson, I'm Brad Muller.
Our thanks to Brad and Coach Anderson. Well, it was a social media sensation when the pictures came out this week. We are talking, of course, about the Boom Bus. Head coach Will Muschamp's new ride to kick off the Spurs Up Tour at Gamecock Club chapters across the state. Why don't you hop aboard the Boom Bus with us here on Gamecock Insider.
Boom Bus is Gamecocks. We're going to be traveling around the state of South Carolina, and we're coming their way. We want people to know we're heading into their town. This makes a statement, and it tells people that the Gamecocks are there. And the concept is to travel around the state. It's a traveling billboard that's going to tell people Coach Muschamp is here, and we're heading your way. Everywhere we go, we're going to 9 locations. We're parking this somewhere that everybody can see right when they drive up. So they'll be able to come around to get their picture taken with it, and it'll just be a neat opportunity for them to see the Boom Bus in person. And what we'll be doing is Coach Muschamp will sign autographs for a period of time for about 30 minutes, and then he'll get up and speak and give an overview of the program and what to expect this upcoming season. The true purpose of the Spurs Up Tour is really to get people excited about the upcoming season and to be able to meet Coach Muschamp in person.
That is the Boom Bus, and Will Muschamp coming to a Gamecock Club chapter this spring near you. Now let's look at My Carolina.
Now, Gamecocks everywhere can support their beloved university year-round at the USC Alumni Center. Our spirit capital is the place to support student learning, connect to each other, and advocate for Carolina, no matter where you are in the world. Alumni, students, faculty, staff, and fans, we are ready to welcome you home. Visit mycarolina.org and stay connected forever to thee.
Painting a brighter future is easy with Future Scholar, South Carolina's tax-deductible 529 college savings plan. The holiday season is a great time to open a Future Scholar account. It's never too early to start investing in your children's future. Learn more at futurescholar.com and let's paint their futures bright.
Win the opportunity to be the next Farm Bureau Insurance fan in the field and witness pregame warm-ups from the dugout. Winners will receive two game tickets, pregame field passes, and autographed merchandise from head coach Chad Holbrook. Visit usccontest.com to register today. Fan on the Field is brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Get the membership advantage.
Turn out the lights.
Why is all your junk in your new car?
The party,
it's not junk. Over.
Thank they you. Say that all good things must end. Call it a night.
Are you kidding me?
Nissan Sentra, J.D. Power's highest-ranked compact car in initial quality. Now get a $149 per month lease plus $500 on the Nissan Sentra.
Carolina and Clemson haven't agreed on much since 1896. It's a healthy multi-sport rivalry. And this year, every head-to-head competition is part of the inaugural certified SC-grown Palmetto Series. So while Gamecocks and Tigers each support their team, we can all support local farmers by purchasing certified SC-grown products. Just look for the certified SC-grown label where you shop and follow your team at palmettoseries.com. It's a matter of taste.
Gamecock Insider is brought to you by Coke Zero. Enjoy everything. By Colonial Life, the benefits of good hard work. And by Wild Wing Cafe, we've got just the thing to make you wild. Gamecock Insider is a production of Gamecock ING Sports Marketing.
Don't forget, a pair of nationally ranked teams roll into town next weekend as South Carolina softball plays host to Alabama and baseball takes on Florida at Founders Park. Make sure to get your tickets. That'll wrap up this week's Gamecock Insider. For all of us at Gamecock Productions, I'm Andy Demetra. We'll see you next time on Gamecock Insider.